EasyRobot.com. Personal robotics for everyone.
So my name is DJ Shirts and I'm a roboticist. And I started a company called Easy Robot, and I've been building robots for many years professionally, doing it for a bunch of different companies. Everything ranging from oil and gas to artificial intelligence to a bunch of other variety of things. So what I've done over my career is I've built robots like this. Okay? Cute, right? Wally. And throughout the time, I was assembling all the ideas that people expect of robots. And technology and robotics hasn't actually taken everything and put it all together. So what I've done is assemble everything I wanted about robotics and everything that movies told you want about robotics. And how I did that was through a few different means. One is I play with toys like this, because these kind of toys, for me, are my method of studying how people overcome the intimidation factor of a new technology. This looks like a silly little fun toy, but the amount of technology that's inside of it, and the things that it's going to do, and I'm going to show you, is something that doesn't exist anywhere else in the entire world except for here in Calgary. It's pretty cool. So, how I did it was, I developed a software package and a hardware platform that allows anybody to build robots. Medical and robots for disability and elderly. So anyone who's got an idea of a robot you want to build, I'm placing the software and the hardware in your hands that you can actually create this. So what I have here is the software program, and I'm going to load up my Wall-E project that I created for this guy right here. So inside of him, here's a toy. I modified him. I put some servos in place of his motors that used to be there, all from the kit that you get from our existing website. And what you see here is going to be, in a second, the control mechanism to actually communicate with the Wall-E. So right now I've connected to him, and I can start him up here. He's initialized. And now I can do a lot of different things with him. So what you see on the screen is what he's actually seeing. So for example, I can put maybe a picture that I've taught him in front of him. And he detected that and responded with a command. Now these commands that are in here right now is because I did a science fair this weekend for the kids, and I had it set up so that he's making some very, very silly commands based upon the actual movie itself. So these are photos, right? He's Eva. Now, if I wanted to follow a ball, for example, I could put the ball in front of him and specify the color. And as you can see here, and he's also trained to acknowledge it like that ball. Okay. Now, if I want to turn this ball, or have him stop tracking it that way, he gets that way taken away too. So I can put camera tracking off and turn movement tracking off. Now, with movement tracking enabled, what I can now do is put the ball in front and have him actually search for the ball. So now, with this Wii remote, I can also drive him and move his arms. And I'm going to push him in front of the ball. Now he's tracking the ball. So, let's move the ball around. Okay? Now these are things that people are able to do with toys. Now can you imagine what you could do if this was inside of a larger skeleton or a larger robot or anything that you can think that you want robots to do. We have everything from people who are 65 years old adding voice recognition to their own wheelchairs. Let's do that right now. Add control. Speech. Recognition. Robot, move forward. I can also plug in these glasses, which allow me to be able to see what the robot sees and control the robot's head when I move my head. So when I look around, I can actually, if you look down, the robot's head is also moving.